These basic principles of good governance were incorporated in the Constitution by our founding fathers. Objective of establishing a welfare state found expression in it. Our Constitution outlines the values that should be fundamental in the governance in our country, and that is why it has been described once by an eminent British Prime Minister, Sir Anthony Eden, that the most significant Magna Carta of socio-economic transformation, just not a mere legal document. Ladies and gentlemen, how do we measure in terms of governance after 66 years of our independence? There is little doubt that we have made great strides in almost all major areas of development. From 1951 to 1979, from the beginning of the first five-year plan, our developmental approach to the conclusion of the fifth five-year plan, the average Indian economy grew 3.5% per year, compared to average 1% GDP growth in the full first half of the 20th century. Today, when we have completed the 11th five-year plan and entered into the 12th plan, despite some shortfalls here and there, the annual average GDP growth during the 11th plan was 8%. Similarly, a country of net importer of food grains, producing only 50 million tons of all sorts of food grains taken together, in 1952, through Green Revolution introduced in 1960, could produce 256 million tons of food grain over a period of 60 years. Today, India is the third largest economy in purchasing power parity. We can certainly be proud of these achievements. But it is equally true that much more remains to be done. The challenges to our governance system are reflected in some important international analyses, which are mainly dependent on the social index. India's ranking in key governance indicators like voice and accountability, political stability, absence of violence, government effectiveness, regulatory equality, rule of law, and control of corruption are lower than compared to the major developed economies, both developed and developing, like France, Germany, Italy, Japan, UK, US, and Brazil. We are at the crossroads of transformation and cannot afford to lose the momentum of change. There are several challenges we face, and we should face them with determination and conviction. And at the root of them is the issue of governance. We have achieved remarkable progress in several of the grids that constitute good governance. In some, our achievements have been greater than others. There is still immense scope to better our participatory decision-making structure, improve the application of the rule of law, enhance transparency, increase accountability, promote greater equity and inclusiveness, and improve consensus-based approach. For the sake of brevity, I will elaborate on some of the few creeds. The incidence of poverty is still around 30%, and it is not something that we can live with. Statistics of economic progress will count for nothing if we are not able to uplift the marginalized sections of the society. Our growth, therefore, must have to be inclusive and sustainable. Ladies and gentlemen, inclusiveness calls for equity in access to basic needs like education, healthcare, and our efforts should be directed at making the entire population literate. I am confident that the flagship schemes in the education sector, such as Sarv Shiksha Abhiyan, Midday Meal Scheme, and Rashtriya Madhyamik Shiksha Abhiyan, would be addressing many of our problems. Affordable health care should be our priority. Many people in this country are forced into poverty due to high costs of medical treatment. It is gratifying to note that the building on the success of the National Rural Health Mission, a new national health mission combining the rural mission and a new Indian urban mission, is being envisaged with a budgetary outlay of over ₹21,000 crores in 2013-14. A healthy population holds the potential to make greater contribution to nation building. Another important aspect in the change in our development paradigm is to be noticed. Today, nobody is talking of the trickling down theory, not even the confrontation direct, but the new terminologies, empowerment with entitlement. Entitlement backed by legal enactment. In certain limited areas, like right to education, right to employment, right to food, right to information, are some of the core of this developmental strategy